children and adults with albinism face multiple challenges which restrict their daily lives. These include visual impairments, extreme vulnerability to skin infections and cancer because they lack melanin in their skin. As a result, most of them die from skin cancer before the age of 40. During a meeting convened to echo their voices on the burden posed by skin cancer among over 5,000 people with albinism in Uganda, different members share heartbreaking stories of battling cancer, while others have lost the battle and put to eternal rest. Salongo Ali Lutalo, a 35-year-old, revealed that he's battling with swelling of his ears that later turned cancerous, which is a life-threatening condition. He shares his story.
Skin cancer wange ajanga nsundo. Wajanga nsundo. Nendoza vya rusago. Nageja ngorumu. Anduma ngano kuria. Omutima gugwayo go kuria. Puli rokwe chawa. Muviringa go cherera Kwe gamba nembera muchivera vera echo kwe chawa. Ng'abantu abalaba ku musayi gwange bagamba ne kati oyo lwaki atutambulirangamu ajatukwasa ekirwadde.
With underlying pain, Ali says, in order to overcome the pain, he has to forego one side of his ear. It's the scare he is not afraid to show anyone because it's through this hard decision that he managed to beat cancer.
Nawuliranga kaseera ke nalimu. Nga ndi mu bulumi obutagambika nga n'olumu ekyokulya kigaana se bazadde bange bafa bwe bamala okufa nasigalawo omu na Katonda kati wembeera awo mba nkyali awo gundi COVID-19 naye najja wajja ndi mu kirwadde ekyo kinduma tekinaba kubeerako nti oba kiwonye era bandeeta eno mu ddwaliro mu kaseera aka COVID nga n'emusawo okukwatako atya kisa mulungi nti we natuuka awo ne dokita yantuukirira ba.
Other people with albinism have spoken out on negative attitudes they face and misunderstandings from their communities. They've urged the government and other organizations to provide them with medication and sensitization programs to skin care.
This is opinion for persons with albinism receiving a prior blood.
Leaders have urged the government to provide quality health care for them. Honorable Bumali Mpindi urged the government to provide chiro guns for people with albinism in order to fight skin cancer.
We need to put our heads together to see that we address these challenges. I know that many people may not be knowing these things, because I am also a person with disability and I represent you in Parliament. But until when Marion told me about this.
Through the event, Alan Tenya, a human rights activist and director of GOBS Foundation, promised to raise funds for the purchase of cryoguns to help in the early detection of precancerous cells and subsequently burning them down, hence reducing cancer death rates among people with albinism.
We are sure that the presence of these machines in various solutions, of course, is going to ease the treatment of skin cancer among people with albinism.
Tenya says this will add on to the existing efforts of the partnered organization source of the Nile Union of Persons with Albinism that currently owns a single cryogen gun used close to 5,000 persons with albinism across the country.
We have been in a position to buy four, and today we have given out two to two beneficiaries, all the organizations which are supporting persons with albinism. The first machine has been taken by the albinism umbrella.
During the event, the albinism community received four cryoguns from GOBS Foundation and says they help to kill precancerous cells from processing into people with albinism. He urged those who receive the equipment to put it into rightful use in a bid to advance the health and livelihoods of persons with albinism.
Now we urge the government, one, to ensure that the liquid nitrogen is accessible in the country, two, that also the gas cylinders are also accessible in the country.
Sekwi Simon Peter, director of Elgon Albinism Foundation, among others, received the cryogen gun. Thank the organization for their support.
80% of persons with albinism in Uganda die of skin cancer. And so today we are privileged that we are getting this skin, nitrogen gun, that will go a long way in trying to help us fight at the challenge of skin cancer.
Peace Navuga for the news.